Hey guys, Servern back here, and today I'm going to be going over sharing my PS3 collection with my buddy Otis. Alright, so the PS3 was the first console that I bought games for that I didn't sell, other than like a few Game Boy games and a handful of other things, but I've never sold a PS3 game. Every game I've purchased, I've kept. I bought most of them around the time of the PS3 or during its generation, but a few of them I picked up after the fact. I bought all of these new, so none of them will have stickers or anything like that on there. But anyway, let's start with Demon's Souls. Picked that up at the time and was not a big fan. It was too hard for me. I never beat that one, like I said, but I did play the PS5 Demon's Souls, the remake, and enjoyed it. But I got through it with a buddy of mine. I'm still not good enough for Souls games. I'm not sure if they're for me. Next game is Devil May Cry. It's like the reimagining Devil May Cry. A lot of people didn't like it. I really liked it. I never played the other ones though, so that's the only one I've ever played, but I really enjoyed it. This is Doom 3 BFG Edition. That was one of the games I purchased after the fact, trying to collect all the Dooms, so I think I have all of them right now. We have Dragon Age Origins. I played a good bit of that, but did not beat it, and you'll have to bear with me. These games, it's been, 10-ish, 15 years since I've played some of these, so this is just going off memory. Skyrim, of course, I've beat that. That's where I beat it, though. I've only beat it on PS3. I did repurchase it on PS4. Don't think there's a PS5 version yet, but there may be. Fallout New Vegas. I have a weird thing with Fallout. So I played Fallout 3, beat it, loved it. That was my first one. I had a buddy of mine play the Game of the Year edition, which is the one I have, I believe. I got the Game of the Year edition as next. But we both played the Game of the Year edition, and he played like all the DLC, was super into it. I think I just played the base game, enjoyed it. Like I said, it was my first Fallout game. But yeah, it was good. But Fallout New Vegas, I don't really like games that allow you to cheat or like, so it's been a long time, so bear with me, but I came up to like a poker table, lost, and then it was basically infinite money because you could just bet and save. And if I'm allowed to cheat or exploit the game, I'm probably going to do it. And I just didn't like that about it. So didn't finish the game, and I think that was one of the reasons why, but you know, it's been a long time. There was one game, Ni No Kuni, and it had a casino. If you've played it, you'll know. But to get to it, you couldn't save right next to it. You had to save way and fight your way to the casino, and I really appreciated that because in my head, I think that's what they were trying to prevent. Anyway, like I said, here is Fallout 3 Game of the Year Edition. Beat that. Liked it. Here is God of War Saga. Includes 5 full games. Let's see, it's got God of War, God of War 2, God of War 3, God of War Origin Collections, which includes God of War Chains of Olympus, and God of War Ghost of Sparta, exclusive bonus content. So I got that, and my goal is to play every God of War game. I've played the first one. I played that last year on the Vita TV, or the PS Vita TV. But anyway, so I have all of them. Except for the brand new one, which I'll get when it goes down to like $40. Let's see. Grand Theft Auto 4. This is the only Grand Theft Auto game that I've actually beat. I've played most of them. Maybe all of them, but most of them I've played, but like at buddies' houses. You know, I wasn't allowed to play them, you know, growing up, some of them. But 4 was, I beat it on the 360 and then went back through it on the PS3. Not sure if I completely beat it, but the PS3 is, I switched from 360 to PS3. So early games in the PS3's life cycle, I don't have, or at least some of them I don't have. But then we get to Heavy Rain. This is a favorite of mine. Me and my buddies will talk about this at work. I love Heavy Rain. Heavy Rain is an amazing game. I think they re-released it on PS4. And you, I don't know if you can see right here, but I have probably 200 to 300 PS4 games that I get new ones. I got one yesterday. I get new ones all the time, so I may do a collection. If y'all like this, then comment, and I may do a PS4 collection, because I've got a lot more PS4 games. But anyway, Heavy Rain is amazing. It's out on the PS4 too, maybe even PC, I think so. Check it out, it's awesome. Ethan! So, next we have the Ico and Shadow of Colossus collection. Haven't played either of those. That was one of the games I purchased kind of after the fact, just collecting games. Or, you know, PS3 games are super expensive, and I think I have every game I want for the PS3. I'm not buying to, you know, for them to go up in value. I just don't want them to go up in value before I have to buy them. So I think I have every PS3 game that I'm gonna want. I have Infamous. Now, this interesting story. Back in the day, PS3 or PlayStation got hacked, and their servers were down for a ridiculously long time. I don't remember all the details about it, but they gave away two free games, and that was one of the choices. Infamous, and I believe I got Little Big Planet, but I always buy physical copies. I'm not a digital guy at all. I do have digital PS3 games, but I'm not even going to go over them, because who cares? I also have Infamous 2. I've played Infamous 1 and 2, and I'm not sure if I beat 2. I need to go back to it. I may have. I'll have to check my trophies. It's been so long. And then I have... Infamous 2 collection includes a super voucher. This is still sealed. I think this came from like Europe. Well, actually, it didn't, because it's T14. I'm not sure what that is, but it's a disc, I believe. And then I have the Infamous 2 collection includes two full games: Infamous Festival of Blood. Infamous and Infamous Festival of Blood, only on PlayStation. So this is still sealed. I think I was trying to get everything that Infamous ever came out with, and I have not looked at these in a while, as you can tell, so I'm not quite sure what that is. But anyway, let's do next is Journey, Collector's Edition. If you haven't played Journey, it's an amazing game. It's short, sweet. I'm not sure if there's still a community out there for it, but I'm sure there is. It also came out on PS4. If you haven't checked it out, you should, because it's really, really cool. Killzone 2. I don't have Killzone 1. Killzone 2, I think, was my first. Yeah, that was my first entryway to it. I really like the Vita Killzone Mercenaries. I was going for the platinum in that, but I think they just shut down the servers. But I may still be able to do it. Anyway, it was awesome. And I like Killzone 2 as well. The Last of Us. That's where I played The Last of Us. No, did I play? I played it on the PS4, I'm sorry. I just bought the PS3 edition, I think. Hazy. But I did beat The Last of Us, I just can't remember where. I liked The Last of Us. Some people say it's like their favorite game of all time. It's not mine, but I did really enjoy it. And now that the TV series is out, I really want to go back and replay The Last of Us. I bought the PS5 version, and just give it another chance and then play the second one. The next game is Little Big Planet, the original one. I'm not sure how many of those came out, but I did like it. You know, it wasn't one of my favorite games of all time, but that was one of those free games that Sony gave out. And I had to buy it physically. So this one is Lego Lord of the Rings. I think I just saw that on Amazon. That's one, a new one, like I said, I bought. I haven't played it, so I'm not sure why I bought that. Oh, I do know why. So Lord of the Rings War in the North. It's another one. I went on like a Lord of the Rings kick for a second. I was like trying to collect all the Lord of the Rings games, and I started and then realized there's just a ton of them, so I bought a few here. So Lost via Domus. If you've ever watched the TV series Lost, that's an interesting game, but that was one of the last games that came out pre-trophies, and they did not patch it in. Man, I wish they would patch it in, because I would go back and like rewatch that series. I love Lost. Love the video game. It's really cool. You're like a photographer, and you lost your memory. It's been a while. But I need to go back and maybe even finish that game. I'm not sure how far I got. Madden 10, who cares? Madden 13, also who cares? I bought those back in the day with buddies of mine from work. We played those. Nobody cares. All right, MAG. Massive Action Game. This is basically a coaster now. MAG is, or was, amazing. To me, it was 256 players online. Online shooter. Not sure how they got it to work, but it worked really well. The gun mechanics were really cool. It was just awesome. If you look at Sir Vern, my gamer tag, it still says Valor, and that's from that game, from the PS3. I kept it. I don't know why. I probably need to update that, but I really, really liked MAG. So I have Mass Effect 2, which, man, that's one of my favorite PS3 games. Amazing. Amazing. I played the original Mass Effect on 360 and switched to PS3, played Mass Effect 2 on 360, on PS3. And then I've got Mass Effect 3, still have yet to play it, but if I do play it, I'll play it on the new Legendary Collection, I think it's called, on PS4. I purchased that. Medal of Honor, limited edition, and it includes Frontline, Medal of Honor Frontline, so I have a digital code, but, whatever, but I have that on my PS3. But I actually liked Medal of Honor. When you'll have to go back and watch reviews for that. But when it came out, it was a huge flop. Like, everyone hated it. I didn't mind it at all. I really liked it. I beat the campaign and even played some multiplayer online. It takes me back to where I used to live at the time. I don't know if you remember, like, where you were when you watched a movie. But I remember where I was when I played that game. Good memories. But anyway, Metal Gear Rising. I was trying to collect all the Metal Gear games. That's another one I didn't play or haven't played yet. I will play all these games one day, or hope to. Metal Gear Solid, the collection, it's got, I think it's got 1, 2, 3, and 4. So, I also haven't played all of them. I started to play them last year or the year before. I'll have to look at my my notes. But I beat Metal Gear Solid 1. Two. I started with 4. That was the first game I played on PS3. If you have not played a Metal Gear Solid game, play them all. But 4 is so, so good. I haven't played 3, but I've heard it's the best, so I can't wait to play that. And I have 5 on the PS4. But anyway, Metal Gear Solid 4, like I said. Man, that game, it came out without trophies. And then after they patched trophies in, I went back in and got a few trophies. I need to go back and just beat that game. That is a game that they need to port to the PS5 or remake. So I have Minecraft Legendary, not Legendary Edition, just Minecraft PS3 Edition, duh. But, everyone does Minecraft. It's awesome. It's great. Need for Speed, Hot Pursuit. I have not really played many racing games as of late. I did play Gran Turismo 7, but that's the first one in years. Right now I'm playing Wreckfest. But racing games are good every once in a while, and I do have a few, but you'll see that that's definitely... I'm no Metal Jesus Rocks. I don't... it's not my favorite genre by any means. Stretch of the imagination. Whatever. Next, I have Need for Speed Undercover. That's actually a really, really good game. Has a cool story, cool ending. Ni No Kuni, The White Witch. I have that on PS3 and PS4. Played most of it on PS4. Didn't finish it. I really liked it, but maybe too childish. Now, it is challenging. The game is challenging. Anyway, I'll probably go back and replay that and review it, because I do like it. I just need to give it another chance. Portal 2, amazing. Man, Portal 1 and 2. I played Portal 1 on the orange box on 360, but Portal 2, it's just an amazing game. It has co-op, which the servers are down. I had issues, but whatever. It's awesome. Play Portal 2 if you haven't. I think you play, of course, you can play on PC too. Pro Evolution Soccer. No idea why I have that. Just 2014. So that's old school. This is arguably my favorite game on the PS3. Red Alert 3. Command & Conquer. Red Alert 3. Absolutely love RTS games. I'll have to do a collection of just all my RTS games, because I have most of them, maybe even all of them that have come out on console, but it's by far my favorite genre, and, strategy games are my favorite, is my favorite genre, and RTS games just knock it out of the park, or used to. They haven't come out with a good one in a while, but love that game on PS3, I've played a ton of it. Red Dead Redemption, the original, amazing, 2 is also amazing, but, waiting for that remake. or port at least anything. We love it. I have Red Faction complete. I guess the first Red Faction. Haven't played that. That was one of the games I purchased after the facts. I have Sonic Ultimate Genesis Collection. These are just some of these games, like that one I purchased after, just collecting. And most of, or all of these, I think, are open. I just opened my games, except for Infamous, but anyway, just bought that to collect it. But I, you know, that's something I'd play and try to platinum, maybe. Star Wars The Force Unleashed, that is a really good game. I really like that game. Tales of the Borderlands, I started to get into Borderlands after the PS3 life, PS4, and played Borderlands, the Handsome Collection, with a buddy of mine, and then started 3, haven't played it much, didn't fall in love with it, but I collected all the Borderlands games, so haven't played that. Terraria, haven't played that. I guess there's more of these I haven't played than I realized, so it's good for me to, you know, jump back in and look at these. Tiger Woods PGA 11, what can you say? Tiger Woods games are great. Right now I'm playing PGA 2K23 and loving it. It's a great game, just platinumed it. Twisted Metal, love the Twisted Metal games. I played the original ones when I was a kid. This was the first one with trophies. The online was great, although I got my butt whooped. Twisted Metal is so good. That game is amazing. The storyline's cool, and they're making a TV series, so keep an eye out for that. That came with Black, Twisted Metal Black, which is a PS2 title, and I think I have that physically down here. Anyway, but anyway, it's a great game. Uncharted, Drake's Fortune, the first Uncharted. Great. But Uncharted 2 takes the cake. Uncharted 2 is one of the best PS3 games, period. It's amazing. Uncharted's great. The first one's good. The second one just knocks it out of the park. The third one, a lot of people, well, there's mixed reviews on this one, but I really enjoyed it. I liked 3 too. Not as much as 2. Order of like 2, 4, 3, 1. 2, 4, 3, 1. That's the order of the ones I like. I have not played the one with the two girls, whatever it's called. I'll own it though. XCOM Enemy Within. So I started to watch an XCOM Enemy Unknown. I started to watch, who was it? Angry Joe. And he's all into XCOM games. It's a strategy game, which, you know, I like strategy games. This one, though, I tried it, and I collected all of them kind of before I tried it, and I don't hate it, I just didn't love it, so. But, you know, like I said, I'd like to give games another chance. You know, sometimes I change my mind. This is the PS3 disc, whatever it comes with. Welcome to PlayStation 3. I keep those. I keep everything. It's sealed still. 3D Dot Game Heroes, that's pretty expensive. It's open, but I bought it new. So that I haven't played it yet, but I definitely will. That's one I got after the fact. Aegis of Earth. So I beat this. That was my first platinum ever. I platinumed it on the Vita. That's for Vita, PS4, and PS3. And I loved it so much on Vita that I bought every version of it, 4 and 3. So I will definitely play that. It's amazing. It's like a tower defense game. Strategy, of course, my favorite genre. Dante's Inferno. Dante's Inferno is really good, really hard, kind of like a Devil May Cry game. Got Call of Duty Black Ops 2. I used to kind of be into Call of Duty games more than I am now, although I'm kind of getting back into Warzone. I love the Black Ops games. I thought I had Black Ops 1. I may up here somewhere. But anyway, Black Ops 2. Alice Madness Returns. I have not played that. That's one of the ones I bought after the fact. Alpha Protocol, same thing, bought it after the fact. It's like a strategy, not strategy, an RPG shooting game, which looks really cool. And then Oregon's Quest, I think that got terrible reviews, but I bought that during my Lord of the Rings kick. I know I have some more. Here we go, right here. I need to organize these better. Army of Two, The Devil's Cartel. Me and my buddy really enjoyed Army of Two. I bought that one there's a few of them. I didn't realize that one was even out, so I bought that one after the fact. Have not played it. Assassin's Creed 2. Before I started actually platinuming games, I got really close on that one. I got like 80%. Assassin's Creed games, believe it or not, that's the last Assassin's Creed I've played is 2. Really liked 1, really liked 2. I don't know why I just never get into the rest of it. Now it's just ridiculous. They come out with them every other day. Battlefield 3, this is still sealed. I went on a Battlefield collection once. I was so excited for Battlefield 2042. Huge failure, but I was so excited. I was like, I'm collecting every Battlefield game. In fact, I bought Battlefield 1942 sealed on PC. I mean, come on, I was getting ridiculous. I was like, I want all the games physically that I can get. But a huge failure. Everybody knows the story of that. I don't know if I've showed Battlefield 4 yet, but that's probably, I don't know if that's my favorite or Battlefield 1 is, but that one's way up there. I love Battlefield 4. The Bigs 2, me and my buddy Caleb played this game a ton online. I love arcade-y sports games. Regular sports games, simulation games are good too, but you can't beat an arcade sports games. It's so much fun. Bioshock, I mean, one of the best games of all time. I just replayed it last year. Bioshock 2, believe it or not, I like better than Bioshock 1. That'll be on my list to play pretty soon, replay pretty soon. I love the weapons. There's a few weapons in there, like proximity mine kind of things that and 2 that I really enjoyed back in the day. Blitz 2, Blitz the League 2. Like I said, I like arcade sports games. I love Blitz. I always have. My Borderlands kick stuff. Borderlands 1. Brutal Legend, this one I've heard is really good. I saw that like on a Hidden Gems video of someone's, and they recommended it, and it looks really good. It's got like Ozzy and all, you know, a bunch of rock stars in there. It looks really cool. The Bureau, that's another XCOM game. Like I said, trying to collect all of them before I played them. Cabela's Outdoor Adventure. My family, I'm a redneck too, but they're more rednecker than me, and they came into town, and I was like, hey, I'll get us a game. So I got that, and we played it like one time. And then there's the original Black Ops. I knew I had it somewhere. And I think that's all of my PS3 games. But the PS3 is an amazing system. I still have it hooked up. Yeah, I really enjoyed it. 360 to me had a better generation than PS3, but I don't regret switching over to the PS3, and now I'm definitely a PlayStation guy. But if you want me to show you, I have PS1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 collections in all of them. Some are bigger than others, but I have 16 or 17 consoles hooked up here, and I'd love to show y'all some more collections of mine. Let me know if you'd like to see that, and anyway, server and out.